When you click on More Info, then Preview a theme in the WordPress repository, you will see something completely different compared with the featured image almost every time. Hi WordPress enthusiasts, my name is Robert and in this video series, I will pick the latest theme on WordPress.org, which I'll try to make it look at least like the preview or the featured image. The latest theme today is Consultant Lite, which looks like this once you hit preview. It looks almost like the featured image above its description, but there are some missing things, so let's see how it works once installed on my website. If I go to Themes under Appearance, click Add New and go to Latest Themes, this is Consultant Lite. Let me check if I have some demo blog posts on this website, which is installed on my local host for testing WordPress things. Okay, I have plenty of demo articles, so I can go ahead and start testing the theme. Let's see how it looks right now on my homepage. As you can see, I have a home section with other things below, but I can't see any slider as the first section. And I also have the sidebar on, which is not like in the preview on WordPress.org. The title is too long, I guess, but I can upload a logo here as well. My menu looks pretty much the same, but with fewer elements, and I can see that there is nothing under the location, phone, and email elements above. I think I will find the settings of these elements in the customizer. So, let's check out the preview again before moving on. This is the slider with some blog posts below. So I'll go back to my dashboard and click on Customize to see where it is and how can I activate the slider. Let me shorten the title a little bit in the site identity. New WordPress themes should be enough. Or I can use only one word, like so. Turning this switch off will display the logo only, which is a common WordPress theme option, and it works only if you select a logo over here. I have plenty of other options, like color settings, header, image, background image, and so on. I think I need to go to the homepage settings and pick your latest posts over here to activate the homepage sections. Exactly. Here is the slider, but the blog section below displays the sidebar, which is not active on the demo. It could be a setting in theme options or front/home template options. Let's check this one, which opens the settings of the slider section and all other sections below. It is the latest blog section where I can turn off the sidebar. No, I think it will be somewhere in the theme options, but before checking those settings, let me go back to the front page template options and play around with some settings. I can disable the slider section border, which is this curved shape, something like the shape divider of Elementor. Then I can select the slider overlay, post category, and so on. I can turn on or off any section on the home page. And if I scroll down, you can see that a portion of the header, which contains the main menu, I guess, it's sticky. I don't know why, but the only thing I can see on my homepage is the latest blog posts and there is no other section active below the slider. Let's check out the selected page options. Just two options here for the selected page and title. I think it's nice that I can rearrange the sections, but I still can't figure out why sections are not displayed on my homepage. Let's go to the theme options. Layout management and pick the global sidebar layout as No Sidebar in this dropdown. Now my demo looks almost exactly like the preview on WordPress.org. Let me check out the page demo in a full preview. I think this WordPress theme looks promising for a professional or business blog, and it has a couple of options that only premium themes offer, like the sticky header, for example. But I still can't figure out why other sections are not displayed below. If you know what I do wrong, please leave a comment below and tell me. If I narrow down the width of my browser, you can see that the theme is 100% mobile responsive and has two menus. To add my own address under the location info of the header area, I need to go to Theme Options and access the top header settings, where the content of the header location field is what you will see under location. New York, for example. And the fields below are for the phone number and email. The header off canvas button text can be edited here, and then you can activate it by going to Widgets, off canvas button, and add any widget. There is no preset for social icons, so you have to create something with the HTML widget or install a social share plugin that gives you a widget too. This is it, guys. As I already mentioned, the theme looks promising for business blogs, but you can use it for a personal blog as well. Do you agree? Let me know in the comments, what do you think about this one? And share some good WordPress themes that I would review in the next episode. Keep up the good work and see you in the next video. Cheers!